Hey guys, Florida Prepper, where we celebrate God, guns, guitars, and all things cool to dudes and dudettes. Hey, right now with our political climate, with everything that's going on, with our commander-in-chief, Joe Biden, and his economic plan, inflation's higher than it's been in 20 years, gas is higher than it's been, eggs are $6 a carton. It's really, really tough to survive right now. I mean, I think they said the average annual outgo currently to basically purchase the same goods and services that you did last year, so no difference, is about $7,000 more a year you're gonna have to spend just to maintain the same lifestyle that you had a year ago. So that sucks. I don't know who's out there thinking that everything is amazing right now with this administration, because it's absolutely not. And now currently, not only have we been funneling money to Ukraine, but now we're gonna start funneling money to Israel. And full caveat, I 100% support Israel. I think what Hamas did is absolutely disgusting. Iran is on the verge of starting World War III with the United States of America. If we go into World War III, the first thing that they're going to hit is the power grid, the water supplies, all the stuff that you would immediately be like, I can't go to the store, I can't put gas in my car, my cell phone doesn't work, and we're now in that off-the-grid lockdown situation. So this is going to be a very quick video. I'm starting a new fun mission. I'm going to take a small amount of money every couple of weeks, and I'm going to invest in non-perishable goods to restock up my pantry. If we go off the grid, if they hit the power supply, if we're out of power for a month or possibly two, are we self-sustainable? Are you self-sustainable? But to have fun with it, do it on a really tight budget, just to see how far you can stretch that dollar. I didn't realize how much fun I was actually having until I'm sitting there, you know, looking for the BOGOs. So I went to all the local stores that I thought I could save money, and I did some price comparison. So just for fun, to do a comparison, I went to Aldi, I went to Winn-Dixie, I went to Save-A-Lot, and I went to Publix. And you know what I found out that was really strange? Publix by far had the best deals out of everybody. Save-A-Lot honestly had the worst. In a lot of cases, their cans of soup were more expensive off the rack than Publix. So what I looked for was BOGOs, I looked for 10 for 10s, I looked for coupons off, and everything that I have here, which is a lot of stuff, cost me $37 at Publix. These were BOGOs. This was 10 for 10. When I did the math on, you know, different things, every one of these, if you bought them individually, would be a buck and a half a can. So I'm saving basically 50 cents a can by getting 10 for 10. I know this is not the healthiest and it's not the most tastiest food on the planet, but you can eat it without even heating it. And if you needed sustenance and the stores have been closed for 3 weeks and you're literally picking your cabbage dry to survive, that's gonna look really good. Publix has a deal right now with the Campbell's four packs, a $2 off coupon. So that makes each can 87 cents. Normally they're almost $1.99. So that's a really good savings. Obviously ramen noodles, $1.19 for six of them. Sorry, it's gonna keep you fed. The biggest thing that I was looking for was bread flour and yeast, because I'm gonna start making my own bread. I have a grill, I have a propane grill, and that is essentially an oven. So we're gonna do some videos on how to make, how to take flour, water, yeast, mix it up, and make your own bread in your grill with your propane. So we're gonna make the top of this part of our chip cabinet. We're gonna start filling that up with our prepping supplies. We'll see how that works. I'll just start adding to it and just start filling that up. That's a decent amount of space. That's probably a month of food. So each 3 weeks or so, I'm going to spend another
$40, $50 and stack it up and just have it there for when we need it.
So until next time, this was just kind of a real quick, hey, let's have fun with this. Like, subscribe. That would really help me out with the algorithms with YouTube. But email me or message me on this and let me know, what kind of deals did you find? What are some really good areas of opportunity for people to start stocking up for World War III when the shit hits the fan and we lose power and we can't go grocery shopping for 4 to 6 weeks or maybe longer? Show me some of your ideas. These are just some of mine. But again, everything here was $37. That's not a lot of money. If you do that once a month, and maybe it takes a year before we actually go into a really serious World War III situation, you're going to have a lot of food. You're going to be prepared. And that's what my channel is all about, just being prepared. So until next time, love your God, love your family, be good to yourself, be good to your friends, and we'll see you on the next one.